Hello friends, I am J.K. Agrawal. I am B.Tech and M.Tech from IIT Roorkee. I have been teaching the JEE and NEET aspirants for last more than 30 years, and my students have been very, very successful and performing very well in their competitive exams. Today we are starting the crash course for JEE and NEET, and will especially focus the technique to solve the multiple choice questions in no time, within fraction of seconds. So that would be our focus. Everyone can solve the questions, but how to crack it with no time, that's the key to success. So today we will be starting with rotational motion, which you find at times the most difficult chapter, but it is very easy, and we'll see how it becomes easy. So let's start with rotational motion. And the rotational motion, first of all, the topic is the center of mass. Here we'll be talking about the rigid bodies. So rigid bodies are those in which the relative position of the particles does not change. For example, this chalk, this is a rigid body. If I try to compress it, the relative position between these two ends is not changing. If you have a soft rod, then if you press, the relative position will change. But why I am saying relative motion? Because if I move the chalk, the position of the particles is changing, but the relative position, the distance between the two, is not changing. So that relative word is important to understand. Now, what is the center of mass? Center of mass is the point where you can assume the whole mass of the body to be concentrated. We can have a body which is having, let's say, different masses. So it may not be a single body, but it may be a system of more than one bodies. And I have to find out its center of mass. So center of mass would be somewhere here, where I can assume that this entire mass m1 plus m2 plus m3 is concentrated. Let's talk about in terms of the coordinate system, x, y, and z axis. These masses are placed at coordinates x1, y1, z1. This m2 is placed at x2, y2, z2, and similarly, m3 is placed at x3, y3. Z3. I have to find out the coordinates of the center of mass, and let's say its coordinates are x bar, y bar, z bar. So then what's the formula? The formula all of us know is m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 plus and so on divided by the total mass m1 plus m2 plus m3 and so on. Now, if we have a continuous body, let's say you have a disk and you have to find out its center of mass. So this is a regular body, so its center of mass would be at its geometrical center. But if it is an irregular body, then its center of mass would be somewhere like this. And we know that the center of mass would be towards the heavier part of the body. For example, if I have two masses, let's say 4 kg and 6 kg, and the distance between them is 20 meter. The center of it is at 10 meter, but it will be towards the heavier mass, so it will be towards the 6 kg. So center is at 10 meter, but the center of mass would be somewhere here towards the heavier mass. Now, if this is a regular body where the mass is continuous, then we can write it integral dm into x upon integral dm. Dm is a small mass over here, and you can assume any coordinate system here also. And then this dm is, let's say, at x distance along the x-axis. So like this we can write the formula. Now integral is always summation, so integral dm means the summation of the mass. So that means this is the total mass, or when I integrate, usually we write like this as a convention. So this way we can calculate the center of mass, and the coordinate what we have calculated is x coordinate. So likewise we have to calculate the y coordinate and z coordinate also of the center of mass. So y coordinate will be m1 y1 plus m2 y2 and so on divided by m1 plus m2 and so on. And in terms of integral also we can write it integral y dm upon integral dm. So exactly the same way we write z coordinate also, which is so this is about the formula. You know how to deal with it, how to calculate it, but now we have to understand that how to make it fast also, and I have to find out the x coordinate of it. In this case I assume this as x-axis and this is my y-axis, let's say. So this is the origin, and center of mass is at this distance, which is, let's say, x bar. So x bar will be m1 is 4 kg, which is at zero distance as regards the x coordinate is concerned, and similarly the 6 kg, this is at 20 meter, divided by 4 plus 6. So what I get is 120 by 10, so 12 meter. This is how do we calculate. So this is one part, but again the calculation anyone can do, we have to understand further also. So simple thing is that if I have two masses, 4 kg 6 kg, this is the center, this is 20 meter, center is at 10 meter, masses are not equal. If they were equal, the center of mass will be at center. If they are not equal, center of mass will be towards the heavier one. So center of mass will be somewhere here, and I know that this divides in the reverse ratio of the masses. So this is 6 kg, so center of mass will divide this distance in the reverse ratio of 6:4. So this distance of the center of mass will be 6 divided by 6 plus 4 into this 20 meter distance. So how much is that? Again 120 by 10, so this is 12. So I can immediately calculate that this is in the reverse ratio, 6:4, or let's say 3:2. So this is 12 meter. I may not calculate complete. So this helps us a lot. Now if I talk about what was happening in case of your JEE 2020 January exam, how was the question from the center of mass? So let's take up this example, which was there asked in 2020. This is 4 meter, 3 meter, 5 meter. This is 1 kg mass. This is 1.5 kg mass. And this is 2.5 kg mass. This question was asked in JEE January 2020, that where will be the center of mass. So these are the three masses. Center of mass somewhere would be here. Let's say its coordinates are x bar, y bar. So this is at 0, 0 origin. This is at x equal to 3, y equal to 0. This is at x equal to 0, y equal to 4. So what I get is x bar equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2. So what is x2? 3 plus, in this case, what is for 2.5 kg mass? X3, x is 0, divided by what is the total mass? So this is 4.5 divided by 5 kg, 0.9 meter x coordinate. And what will be the y coordinate? If you see, so y coordinate is same thing again, 1 kg y coordinate is 0, 1.5 kg y coordinate is 0, and third mass 2.5 kg y coordinate is 4, divided by what is the total mass? 5. So this is 10 by 5 equal to 2 meter. So this was the question asked in JEE. So my answer is 0.9 and 2. So you can see that the question is very easy if you have understood the concept. Pick up the other example which was asked in JEE again in 2020 January. So the question was that you are given a sheet, and sheet is having size 2 meter and 3 meter. Out of this sheet, we have, let's say we are cutting this piece, so remaining is this part. And we have to find out its center of mass. So now, how to find out its center of mass? Again, the same thing, I assume that this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and the coordinates are 0, 0, this is x is 2, y is 0, for this x is 0, y is 3, for this x is 2, y is 3. Now I can assume that its surface density or mass per unit area is sigma. So how much will be the mass? How much will be the mass of the total portion? The total area is 2 into 3, so mass is proportional to area. Total mass is 2 into 3 and mass per unit area. This mass I have deducted out of the total mass. So this is what I want to explain you here, that when you were adding the masses, you were applying the formula x bar equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 and so on. But when I am deducting some mass out of a bigger mass, let's say out of m1 I am deducting m2 mass, then my formula will obviously become m1 x1 minus m2 x2 upon m1 minus m2, because what mass is remaining now? M1 minus m2. Let's say I add another mass m3, so it will become plus m3x3, and here also will become plus m3. So whatever mass you are adding is coming plus, whatever mass you are deducting, it will come as minus in the numerator also, in the denominator also. So here the bigger mass m is 6 sigma, the small m is this mass which I am deducting out of it. So this has size, this point is at the mid, so this is 1, 0, and this is x is how much? 1, and y is 2. So it has size 1 meter by 2 meter. So its area is 1 by 2 into sigma. This is 2 sigma. This is 6 sigma. So if I put the things here in this formula, this is 6 sigma is my first mass, and x1. X1 is its center of mass coordinate. So for this bigger mass, what is the center? Its geometrical center? Its geometrical center is this. So this is x1. What is the coordinate of it? This is x is 1, and y is the center of this. This is 3, so center is 1.5. Similarly, the x2 is the center of mass of this portion. So that will be center, geometric center of this. Geometric center of this, this is x2. So x2 will be what? See, this is 1. So geometric center, this is 0.5, this is 1. So how much is this? 1.5. This total distance is 2. Its center is at 1. So what is the y coordinate? 1. So I simply put the values here now. X1 is 1 minus m2 is 2 sigma into x2. X2 is 1.5. This is the complete coordinate x2, y2, and this is x1, y1. So x2 is 1.5, and m1 minus m2 is 6 sigma minus 2 sigma. So what I get is 6 sigma minus 3 sigma upon 4 sigma. So this is 3 by 4, which is 0.75 meter. And similarly, when you calculate the y coordinate, so y coordinate is m1. So in my case, m is capital M. I can put it like this. Y1 minus small m into y2 divided by m minus m. And capital M is 6 sigma into y1 is 1.5. y2 is 1. So 1.5 minus 2 sigma into y2, as I said, is 1. So if I put these values, it's quite easy. You can see this is 9 sigma minus 2 sigma upon 4 sigma. So this is 7 by 4 equal to 1.75. So my coordinates of the center of mass are, what are the coordinates? X bar is 0.75 and y bar is 1.75. So this was the question from center of mass in JEE January 2020. So you can see that the questions are very easy if you have understood the concept. So if we finally conclude, whichever mass we are adding, it is plus, whichever mass we are subtracting, it is minus in the numerator and denominator both. So this way we can calculate the center of mass if the Cartesian coordinates are given of different masses. So we know the coordinates, Cartesian coordinates of the center of mass of the system of bodies. Now if you are given the position vector of the bodies instead of being given the Cartesian coordinates, then how to handle it? Let's understand that also. We are given different masses, m1, it is over here, and its position vector, you know, is represented like this. These are my axes, and similarly I have m2 mass over here, and its position vector is r2 vector. Likewise, I have another mass m3, its position vector is r3, and center of mass would be somewhere in between. Let's say it's here, and its coordinate I am not calculating now. What I am calculating is the position vector. So the position vector of the center of mass r would be, so this is the position vector of the center of mass. This will be m1 r1 plus m2 r2 plus and so on, divided by m1 plus m2 and so on. And same way again, if you are deducting some mass, then you have to put it like this, m1 r1 plus m2 r2. If I am subtracting some mass, let's say, so this is when you are removing m3 out of total mass. So this is the formula, basic formula. So if some mass is being removed, it will become minus. If we are adding all the masses, then every mass is plus. So this is about the position vector of the center of mass. Now we know the velocity. Velocity is what? dr by dt. So we differentiate all this. So what we get is the velocity of center of mass. So velocity of center of mass, how do we write the expression for it? Velocity of center of mass, same way, VCM equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2 and so on upon m1 plus m2 and so on. Likewise, if I have to write the formula for the acceleration of center of mass of different masses, and I have been given that the masses are having accelerations, let's say m1 is having acceleration a1, m2 is having acceleration a2, and I have to find out the acceleration of the center of mass. So again the same thing, we differentiate it once again and we get acceleration of center of mass equal to m1, and a1 is the acceleration of m1, plus m2 a2 and so on, divided by, so this way I get the acceleration of the center of mass of a system of bodies for which I am knowing the accelerations of different masses. And we all know what is MA. MA is the force. So what is M1, A1? This is the force acting on mass M1. So that means, what is M1, A1? F1, force acting on mass M1. What is M2, A2? The force acting on mass M2. And this is divided by total mass of the system. So what I am getting finally is F1 plus F2 plus F3, these are the forces acting on different masses M1, M2, M3. So total is the total external force. So this is total external force, and what I get is total external force equal to M into ACM. So this is the total external force acting on the system, and this is the acceleration of the center of mass of the system. So this is a very important conclusion. From here we understand that if the external force on a system, if the external force on the system is zero, then the center of mass will have no acceleration. If F external equal to zero, then ACM equal to zero. So we have lot of examples of this. For example, you have a boat, and this is the shore, and let's say the boat is of 400 kg mass, and a person who is having some mass of 100 kg is standing in the boat, and there is some combined center of mass of this system, man plus boat, and that is, let's say, here, which is at some distance from the shore. Now, if the man moves on the boat to this side, so what is the external force acting on this system? No external force, because the man is moving inside the boat. This is all internal change within the system. There is no external force. So there will be no acceleration of the center of mass. So center of mass will not change. What will happen? When the man moves to the right, this boat plus man, this system will move to the left, so that the center of mass will still remain here. Likewise, we have another example that you have two masses, M1 and M2, they are experiencing the gravitational force of attraction. So how much is the gravitational force of attraction? G M1 M2 by R square. So will the center of mass of this system change if the masses move towards each other due to the gravitational force of attraction? Let's say after some time they reach here, but still the center of mass position will remain same, because gravitational force is an internal force, it is not the external force. So when it is not the external force, so the center of mass will not change. Similarly, if you have the charges Q1, Q2, and the distance between them is R, and let's say they are experiencing the force of repulsion. What is that force of repulsion? It will be same in magnitude, and this is KQ1, Q2 by R square. And because of this force of repulsion, after some time, they move and they reach here. But center of mass earlier was here, and now also will be at the same place, because this force of repulsion is an internal force, this is not an external force. So I hope you have understood the concept of center of mass, how to calculate it, what is the formula, and it does not change due to the internal forces. If external force is zero, the center of mass will not change. And we have also dealt with the two questions of center of mass which were asked in this JEE January 2020 exam, and you have seen that the questions were easy to solve if you have understood the entire concept of center of mass. Now we'll take up the next topic subsequently.